Kudos to the religious leaders in the UK who have been ringing the alarm about the increase in reports of domestic abuse in their communities during the long periods of social isolation. But at the same time, fuck them for how little they've done to address the underlying problems in their theology that promote that shit. This is coming from an article in The Independent that a lot of people sent me about leaders in Muslim, Jewish, Christian, Hindu, and Sikh communities warning that women in extremely religious groups are the most vulnerable to domestic abuse and least likely to seek help. Now, obviously, it's not a problem exclusive to religion by any means, but it certainly tends to rise in conjunction with religiosity, so much so that even the religious leaders feel the need to point it out. And gotta be honest, I can't help but wonder who the fuck they're warning. Aren't they the ones who should be getting that warning? Like, hey guys, up there your misogynistic scribblings, or you're gonna keep getting young women killed for flirting and shit. So as much as I want to pat them on the back, the very fact that they're warning us is a pretty good indicator that they don't deserve it. Of course, it doesn't help that the other coronavirus story everybody was sending me this week was an army chaplain who was blaming it on abortion. Anthony Kazarnovich, and I probably murdered his name, but we do that to babies all the time, so who cares? Anyway, Tony K wrote a blog where he said, among other bullshit, quote, out of one side of our mouths, we pray to God to bring an end to the deaths of innocent, helpless human beings from COVID-19. Out of the other side of our mouths, we seek boastfully, proudly, of killing millions of innocent, helpless human beings by abortion, end quote. And I'm still waiting to see this in action. Anti-abortion zealots always tell me about it, but I have yet to come across somebody proudly boasting about their abortion score. Anyway, he goes on to imply that God's ignoring us about the COVID deaths because we're ignoring him about the aborted babies. So, middle-of-the-road proposal. What if God just gives all the fatal COVID to the fetuses we were going to abort anyway? Win-win. And I got one final asshole for you before I wrap up this week. Superior Court Judge John F. Russo Jr. is a piece of shit. This motherfucker berated a sexual assault victim in his court for having the audacity to seek a restraining order against her assailant. He asked her if she tried closing her legs or calling the police, and then apparently joked about it to other court staff after she left. Well, it turns out that in this instance, the government got it right. First, he was suspended without pay for 3 months, and then the Supreme Court of New Jersey went one step further and removed him from the bench. What's more, he's been permanently banned from being a judge in the state for the rest of time. And keep in mind that this is the state that let Ken DeVecchio be a judge. So on that brief glimpse of a silver lining, I'll say my goodbyes and hand things back over to Noah and Heath.